Socrates. How's your patient?
You were gone so long, he didn't survive.
I'm sorry, Hippocrates. We took more time because this Misos helped me save my own patient.
Sometimes science requires tough decisions.
If we're finished here, I'll take some time and write down what I remember of your notes, Hippocrates.
I'll go see the priests for more information about my mother.
Come with me. You've had a busy day. The importance of diet to maintaining one's health cannot be overstated.
What good can one apple really do?
Well, taken daily, they can keep the doctor away. But to more serious matters, I know why you're here. You're looking for your mother.
You remember her?
I was young then. I didn't know how to help. I turned her away. But her look of determination and despair was burned into my mind. It has never left me, and it never will. After, I swore to Apollo that I wouldn't turn away another patient, that I'd dedicate my life to the cause. She made an impression on me. Your brave mother did.
She would be happy to know that.
I sent your mother to the sanctuary of Asclepios. Tell the elder priest a treatment for the sacred disease will soon be available to any patient who needs it. Then he may talk to you.
Thank you for everything, Hippocrates. I'll go see him now. To talk to him. The sanctuary of Asclepios, god of medicine. I'd rather trust a physician than a... There he is. He's over there.
Filthy!
If you're here for your purification bath, you'll have to come back another time.
I'm here for information.
In that case, you can go straight to Hades.
I need to know about a Spartan woman who came through here many years ago.
Did that eagle of yours sit in your ears? I'm under strict orders not to talk to any mercenaries. Especially not about Spartan women or injured babies.
I never mentioned a baby.
Think you're so smart? Many women pass through with babies. Now leave me. I have my own problems to deal with.
Maybe I can help you.
Snakes!
Snakes.
They're everywhere! Must have escaped from the Tholos. We keep them for treatments, but they invaded the bathhouse.
The snakes killed someone?
A patient was purifying himself when they slithered in. Turns out he's terrified of snakes. Fell over dead! Now the snakes have made him their home.
What if I took care of your snake problem? Would you talk to me then?
Oh, most definitely. The purification bath is crucial in the path towards healing.
I'll clear out these snakes in no time. Icarus could use a good feast.
Try not to kill them. Lorios will be furious if you sacred snakes get chopped to bits.
Then how am I supposed to deal with them?
Snakes are drawn to the bath's heat. Flood them with cold water, and they'll slither back to their hole. There's an underground pipe that may help you.
I'll take care of your snake problem. Then, you'll tell me what I need to know. Opening it should flood the bath and get rid of the snakes.
And? Is the bathhouse free of snakes?
I flooded the bathhouse with cold water.
Good riddance!
Well?
Well what?
I took care of the snakes. Now you're going to tell me about the Spartan woman and the baby.
I actually don't know anything. It was before my time. The man who does know is Miven, but he won't tell you. He won't tell anyone anything!
Unluckiest snakes! At least, I got a name. Miva. I need to stay hidden.
Greetings, young one. Come to offer Asclepios a sacrifice?
No. But I'm searching for a Spartan mother who may have.
The great goddess Hera guides many mothers to the sacred place. Surely I'm too feeble to remember them all.
What are these stone slabs for?
These are records. We document all who pass through, their illnesses, treatments, so that the glory of Asclepios can be celebrated.
Then I don't need your memory. I just need to find the right stone.
Yes, of course. That's very wise indeed. If only I had the time to help you.
Listen, I'm not here to hurt you. I'm just looking for my mother.
It's Chrysis. She's got every priest in the sanctuary under her thumb, and she'll squash anyone who feeds information to the Eagle Bearer.
Then don't tell me anything. Just bring me to the stone that can.
Follow me then. Quickly. We must be discreet.
Lead the way.
This way. Over here. If anyone is watching, they'll have my head.
What kind of sanctuary isn't safe for its priests?
Times have changed, Eagle Bearer.
Μάκα, πολιόνιμε, πυρίπολε και τελετάρχα. Θεόν πάτε, ειδέ και ιέ.
Ah, I remember this tale, written during the time of the great Helot revolt. You would have been only a child.
I don't need the history, just the details.
It tells the tale of a woman with worms in her throat. Asclepios took off her head so we could remove them, then reattached it in her sleep.
Definitely not the right one. I wonder what Hippocrates would think of these treatments.
Hippocrates is a fine healer. Showed so much promise.
Showed? He's healing the sick right now.
He puts too much faith in his hands, and not enough in the gods.
When it comes to life and death, I prefer hands. Are all the testimonies so outrageous?
Writers today, Thucydides, Euripides, the petulant Aristophanes, all of them try for realism. But what really inspires is greatness, magic, gods. This one tells the tale of a man with sword wounds. A pack of dogs licked him clean, and Eureka! A man's best friend indeed.
This is hopeless.
These stories give people hope even better.
Well, I'm losing mine. Tell me about Chrysis.
A very powerful, dangerous woman. But it was not always so. She was abandoned here as a child and taken in by the priests. Taught the ways of the gods. She learned very quickly. Was very strong-willed. And before too long, it was the priests who listened to her. She was loved. But there's an anger in her heart that could not be soothed. So when her methods turned to madness, anyone who opposed her got...
Got what?
I've already said too much.
And what about this one? Let me guess. It tells the tale of a blind woman who had her eyes licked by snakes.
It reads of Sparta. Came here with child. Sought pity from the gods.
Why is most of it scratched out?
I'll just tell you. I know this one by heart. The Spartan woman arrived filthy and bleeding from her travels. We cared for her, gave her food, a bath, and she left. Where she went, I do not know. The child could not be saved.
Who does know where she went?
We've been spotted. Meet me later, near the olive tree of Heracles, at the entrance of the sanctuary. I may have something for you.
And what do we have here? A priest and a mercenary out for a friendly stroll?
May the gods be with you, Plistos. I was just on my way to the archives when this Mystheus bumped into me.
Is that so? And what were you both chatting about so fervently, might I ask?
I'm filthy and could use a good bath. The kind priest here was pointing me in the direction of the bathhouse.
Yes, that's correct. The bathhouse is right over there. Now, if you'll excuse me.
The baths are for healing the sick, not for washing the blood off one's hands. Leave.
That old priest, hiding by the tree. The tree of Heracles? I'm not sure if it's loved more for its legend or its olives. Now, where is that priest?
I thank you for your discretion, Eagle Bearer. Chrysis has many eyes and ears throughout the sanctuary.
What else can you tell me about the Spartan woman and child?
The woman left the child's blanket behind. We tried to return it, but it was too painful a memory for her.
Where did she go? What happened to the child?
So, Chrysis was right. You knew the ruse, Timoxenos. You will suffer her wrath.
Pleistos! Please!
Get behind me, priest. I'll deal with these two.
For glory!
Asclepius spare her from suffering.
Will she live?
Not unless the gods heed our prayers. Many sick Athenians have arrived in Argolis recently, and very few have left. This poor girl has the same sickness.
Is there anything I can do to help?
I was warned of the Eagle Bearer. Wants nothing but drachmae for blood, I was told.
We're wasting time, priest. We can discuss what I want when this sick girl's needs are taken care of.
Her illness seems to have no cure, and it's spreading. Our sacrifices have done little to draw the attention of the gods. Pigs, goats, all have fallen on deaf ears. We need a beast whose blood will ignite these flames for Asclepius to see.
What did you have in mind?
There is a rumor of a bull with skin as white as snow roaming the sanctuary outskirts. Head west of here. Towards the coast. Bring it to me alive, and we'll offer a sacrifice the gods cannot ignore. I'm touched you will help these people, but I know why you're really here. Chrysis made all priests swear oaths to seal our lips in the face of the ego-bearing Mystios, or forfeit our lives. But I serve the gods and the sick. My oaths are to them.
The outskirts are vast. Can you be more specific about the location of the bull?
Last I heard, it was grazing on Mount Corypham, near the Asini ruins.
Tell me about Chrysis. She has everyone terrified.
We taught her everything we knew about healing, about the gods. Then she found new teachers, people in masks. They changed her, turned her heart black. They became her gods.
I'll find this bull for you.
Thank you.
white bull. Am I too late? Ella. Look like he died willingly. I'll take his heart with a sacrifice. It'll have to do.
Oh, not the best feeling.
I hope this heart is enough. If they want the whole bull, they can come get it themselves.
Please help our daughter.
Did you find the white bull?
I couldn't bring it back alive, but I did manage to collect its heart.
This won't be enough to please Asclepios. The beast died unwillingly, and with just a heart, we'll only be able to pray for one life.
Please, Mythios. The white bull you killed was mine. My farm feeds half of our lease. If I die, people will starve.
I beg you! My husband was killed by the sickness. I have two small children. Who will take care of them if I die? I am wealthy, and will pay you for this blessing.
It's okay. Give the sacrifice to them.
You did this. You choose whose prayers get heard by the gods.
I know what it's like to be small and forsaken. Pray for the girl.
You regret this!
Not an easy choice, Mystios. But it's been made. The rest is in the hands of the gods.
I did my part, priest.
The Spartan woman you're after.
You've met her?
Her visit to the sanctuary is legendary. But sadly, it was before my time. The man you want is Medon, the elder priest. He spoke of her often. That is, before he cut out his tongue.
Cut out his tongue?
When he's not healing the sick, he's in the guesthouse. Spends a lot of time being tended to by the servants.
Thank you. I won't forget you helped me.
And these people won't forget you helped them.